Hey guys, NeoScyther here, getting back to the Pokemon Blue Nuzlocke Challenge. As we take a look at our Pokemon list, we have Bulby and BJ. And, yeah, this is going to be fun. I've already tried this segment once, trying to get to Pewter City. Got there and realized just how badly I was going to have to completely grind up Bulby. So this here is Route 2. And I've yet to encounter anything in Route 2. Since I have a Pidgey, if, according to my rules, if a Pidgey is the first thing I find, it does not go against my one Pokemon per area encounter. And it's a Caterpie! Yay! Get in the ball. Yay! And I have my first Pokemon for this area, or for this session. Well, yes, I will give a name to Caterpie. Can't spell. I'll name him Wormy. And now, Rules Loophole. Viridian Forest is a completely separate area. Alright, time for a trainer battle. Against a bug catcher. And he has two Pokemon. And he's going to start out with a Weedle. So what I've learned when I tried this the first time is I'm going to have to grind the crap out of Bulbasaur. Especially once I get Leech Seed, because that's going to really help the grinding. And there's my Leech Seed. No, that I'm going to really grind him out here. I may have to ultimately switch out. Or be careful once I get down to about 7 HP left, I might have to end up using a potion. Okay, I helped. So basically, I'm going to have to grind Bulby until I get to level 13. Hi. You look like I could beat you, because you're a bug catcher. At least he won't do me much at this point. But it is an extra point of health back. Heck no, I'm not changing. Because it's a Kakuna. It only knows one move. In fact, since all I can do is harden. I can take down Kakuna just by sitting here. Not the greatest way of, taking out Kakuna, but hey, it heals me. I think I'm about to the point where, yeah, Growl's not gonna do anything either now. That'll make things go a little faster. Alright, let's go ahead and use a couple tackles here. I think Leech Seed is actually doing more than Tackle. That is hilarious. And nope, because I need to frickin' grind up Bulbasaur. Alright. Awesome. So progress here and we get a antidote. You know, I'm trying to avoid most wild Pokemon areas. I still have yet to encounter my wild Pokemon for this area. Well, crap. On the upside, actually, let's do this. I do need to level Bulbasaur, but since a wild Kakuna and Metapod can only harden. I'll just swap out and gain some shared experience. So sadly, because I'm not going to catch a Metapod when I have a Caterpie. Especially one that can only do Harden. So it means for Viridian Forest, I will not have caught anything and I cannot catch anything now. which actually works okay for me. I think this is the only Pokemon this trainer has, which is good because I'm about out of tackles. Okay. About two or three more turns, I should be good. And once more. Okay, I should be able to deal with a wild Caterpie, okay. As I stated in, a while back, I may edit my rule about healing. Mainly because it's going to make grinding a chore, because I will eventually run out of moves. My main rule with healing was I was only going to use a Pokemon Center once per town, unless it's a town with a gym, which I'd use it twice. And that gets me out of there. And technically on to Pewter City. No, wrong button. What I could do if I wish. Actually, where's the Pokemon here? You can see that's the Pokemon Center. But I want to see what kind of stuff the Mart sells. You bought a Magikarp. So I've got 8 potions. I'm going to buy a couple more of those. Keep hitting the wrong button. I'm used to the 3DS where X opens your menu. Let me see its stats. I've only got two more tackles left. I think I'm going to take a risk. This is going to be a big risk. And that risk is fighting this trainer. Reason is his Pokemon are level 11. Okay. Here's the risk in that. Oh boy. Yeah, this is where I'm gonna have a problem. I'm now completely out of tackle. So, I need to start using potions to keep Bulby alive to get me through this. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and use a potion. I'll try to use. No. This is, like I said, this is all a major risk. Because I'm completely out of tackle. So I'm literally relying on Leech Seed to get me through this. Thankfully, Sandshrew likes to constantly use Sand Attack. Now, if I keep trying to use Leech Seed, what happens? It'll say he evaded the attack because he's already seeded. Okay. So I'm going to keep using Growl because that will make his attacks almost useless. Unless it's a crit, of course. Hmph. I just gotta keep an eye on my health. I should be good at this point. The main goal is to try to get to level 13 so I can learn Vine Whip. I'm not sure if Leech Seed is technically super effective against Brock's Pokemon. So six more turns, I'm going to start using Struggle. Hopefully I won't get to that point. Because he would have to constantly keep critting me. Because this point is literally, he's taking two damage from me, and I'm taking it right back. Okay, so I got three more turns, but it shouldn't take that long. Oop. I'm just going to say it evaded the attack because... I don't know if that's because the accuracy is so low because of Sand Attack, or if literally because... Okay. It's just the fact that he's already seated. And... that got me out of that jam. That put me right at level 12. Okay, with that said, I go back out now. And I use my first heal. Basically, my rules for using the Pokemon Centers were I would heal once before the gym, and I can heal once before the gym battle fight, gym leader fight, and once after it. This is my before heal. And I need to see how much experience I have left to go before I hit 13. Okay, that's my goal, is to hit 13. Where am I at? ...106 to level up. Okay. So, 106 to level up. This, I can't catch a Pokemon here, because this is still considered part of Route 2. Okay. I don't know how many level 5 Pidgeys it's going to take me to take down. Or to get me up to the next level, so we're going to find out. Looks like about 3 or 4. Maybe 3. Tatas aren't going to get me very far in this quest. Okay, be back a brief moment here because, hey, real life happens and I just missed a phone call. So, take out this Pidgey real quick here. Alright, and that should learn me Vine Whip. Yes, it does. Okay, Vine Whip learned. I will be back momentarily. I gotta take care of something. I gotta love when real life happens, and just to show that absolutely nothing changed. Last thing I did was I leveled up, and I learned Vine Whip. So with that said, I'm gonna take a small bit of time before we go to the gym here, and I'm going to try to level another one of my Pokemon here real quick. Easy way to do this. You have to switch out. I got BJ to level 4. Actually, to be honest, I got a better idea. I'm going to keep BJ out, I'm going to go to the gym, and the first thing I'm going to do is switch out to Bulbasaur. In fact, let me go to my items real quick here, because I am going to use a potion. Do I want to? No, I'm not going to use a potion up start, or up front. I can't think. But, it is time to take on Brock. And we get the awesome gym leader theme. So first up is Geodude. Now I'm sending out... No, get out of there, BJ. You can have the experience, though. Now this does let me check something. We're going to Leech Seed real quick here. And do I gain a lot of HP off of Leech Seed? Nah, not really. But this is why I want a Vine Whip. It makes quick work of this gym. And of course I will. Come on out, BJ. That's enough, BJ. And there goes Onyx. Yep. Now you know why I chose Bulbasaur when this started. And I get the Boulder Badge. And I get a TM34, which I think is Bide. Yep. Yeah, I completely forgot what Bide did, so I'm really glad that I took down Onyx in one hit. Alright, since that didn't take long, I'm going to hold up on my trip to the Pokemon Center real quick here. And we're going to level Wormy a small bit. In much the same way we leveled BJ briefly, we're going to swap him back out for Bulby. Thank you. So I figured I'd get a small bit of grinding done here at the end. Actually, no, that's not going to be that much grinding, to be honest, so... I'll go ahead and use my, Yeah, I'm going to have to wait till I get to a trainer battle to do that. So, with that, I'll go and heal up my Pokemon. And with that, that pretty much ends this session. So, we got to, Pewter City, took down Brock, and got our first badge. And, well, so far so good. So, I thank you for watching, and the next time we start up, we'll be heading towards Cerulean City. Which, I think that means we have to go through Mount Moon. Oh, the Zubats. So, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.